Hello friends, this video on triangles part 14 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching this video, please make sure that you have watched part 1 to part 13. Let's take one more example. ABC is a quadrilateral with AB is equal to AD. Bisector of angle BAC and CAD intersects BC and CD at point E and F respectively. We have to prove that EF is parallel to BD. Let's draw the quadrilateral ABCD. This is the quadrilateral ABCD. And we are told that AB is equal to AD. That is, this side is equal to this side. Correct? Bisector of angle BAC and angle CAD. So let's draw this line so that we can get at least angle B and AC and CAD. And then we'll draw the bisector. So we have joined AC. Thus, we have got angle BAC and CAD. The angles in the question. Now the question says the bisector of angle this, that is the bisector of angle BAC and the bisector of angle CAD intersect BC and CD at point E and F. So let's draw the bisectors. So this is the bisector of angle CAB. So here this angle is equal to this angle, correct? And it meets at the point E. Similarly, the bisector of angle CAD intersects side CD at point F, correct? So here you say that this angle is equal to this angle. So again say this is 1, this is angle 1 dash, this is angle 2 and this is angle 2 dash, correct? So what are given? So light things given. So given is, one is AB is equal to AD, that is the first thing given. Angle 1 is equal to angle 1 dash, second thing given, and angle 2 is equal to angle 2 dash. Now we have to prove that EF is parallel to BD. So let's draw BD and EF. This is BD and this is EF. So how to go about this question? If you observe carefully, if you have to prove that EF is parallel to DB, that means if we can somehow prove that CF by DF is equal to CE by B, it solves a purpose, correct? So let's put this as X, this is Y, and this will be X dash and this will be Y dash. If we can prove that X by Y is equal to X dash or Y dash, our problem is solved. That's the best way to prove that EF is parallel to BD. Correct. Now, what we can do, what we can observe that in this triangle, if you see CAB, if you see this X dash Y dash component comes, and there is nothing but AB by AC by angle bisector theorem. And in this triangle, CAD, if you see here also AC is common, and AD is all equal to AB only. So here also AD by AC is equal to X by Y, correct? So that means using these two we can get the answer. So let's try. So we can say that AD by AC, that is equal to Y by X, or I'll say that is equal to DF by FC, and there is nothing but Y by X. Why? AF is angle bisector of DAE. Correct? That is one equation. Similarly, in this triangle, if you see CAB, we'll get AB by AC, that is equal to BE by EC, that's nothing but Y dash by X dash. Why? Because here AE is angle bisector of CAB, angle CAB, correct? Now we know that AB is equal to AD, we know this, correct? So AB is equal to AD and AC is also equal to AC. So we can say that both are equal actually, equation 1 and equation 2 are equal. Why? Since AB is equal to AD, that is given, you see this is given. since this is equal, I can say both are equal. So I can say that y by x is equal to y dash by x dash. If I'm saying y by x is equal to y dash by x dash, that means EF has to be parallel to BD. Correct? If I'm saying that y by x is equal to y dash by x dash, or x by y is equal to x dash by y dash, that means EF is parallel to BD. Correct? So what we have done here? We have observed that we were supposed to prove EF is parallel to DB. Then we observed that if we can prove x by y is equal to x by y dash, we can prove that EF is parallel to DB. To do that, we were told that AF is angle bisector of angle DAC, that is angle 2 is equal to angle 2 dash, and angle 1 is equal to angle 1 dash. So we have used angle bisector theorem to get the value of x by y and x by y dash, and we found that both were equal. Let's take one more example. O is any point inside the triangle ABC. The bisector of angle AOB, BOC, COA meets the side AB, BC in the point D, E, F respectively. We have to prove that AD into BE into CF is equal to DB into AC into FA. So let's draw this triangle. This is the triangle, and let's mark this ABC points. So we have this triangle ABC. Now it says O is any point. So let's take any point, this point, and let's say this is O. Now the question says bisector of angle AOB, BOC and COA, right? So let's join these points AOC, this AO, OB and OC. Why? Because the question says the bisector of angle AOB, BOC and COA meets the side AB, BC and CA. So let's first join these points. So once we have joined this point, we have got this. Now the question says the bisector of angle AOB, BOC and COA meets the side AB, BC and CA in point D, E and F respectively. So let's draw the bisector of angle, these angles. So the bisector of angle AOC, AOB and BOC, at the question says bisectors of this angle, and let this point be DE and F. So here if you see, since this is angle bisector, this is a, let's suppose angle 1, this will be angle 1 dash. If this is 2, this is angle 2 dash. If you assume this is 3, this is 3 dash. Now what we are told? We are told that a light given is angle 1 is equal to angle 1 dash, angle 2 is equal to angle 2 dash, angle 3 is equal to angle 3 dash. That's what we are given. We have to now prove that AD into BE into CF is equal to DB into EC into F. How to approach this problem? Let's do one thing. The first thing, we know that these OD is angle bisector of AOB, O is angle bisector of BOC, and OF is angle bisector of AOC. So let's write the angle bisector theorem thing, that is AO by OB is equal to AD by BB. This first equation. Same thing we'll use for this triangle now, BOC. OE is the angle bisector. So we can write BO by OC is equal to BE by EC. Equation number 2. And third equation we'll write OC by AO is equal to FC by AF. These are the three equations that comes to our mind the moment we see angle 1 is equal to angle 1 dash, 2 is equal to 2 dash, and 3 is equal to 3 dash. Right? Now if you observe AD, BE, CF, AD, BE, CF are all in numerator, DB, EC, FA, DB, EC, FA are all in denominator. Also, if you multiply all these three, everything will get cancelled on the right hand side. Because AO gets cancelled here, OC gets cancelled here, BO gets cancelled here. So let's multiply 1, 2 and 3. So what we get, we multiply 1, 2 and 3, we get AO into OB into BO into OC into OC into AO is equal to AD by DB into BE by EC into FC by AF. Correct? OB, OB cancel, OC, OC cancel, AO, AO cancel. This becomes 1. Or we can say that AD into BE into FC is equal to OB into EC into AC. And that is what we are supposed to do. Very simple, what we have done. The first thing that came to our mind was, since OF, OE and OD were angle bisector of these three angles, we wrote the angle bisector theorem. And then we observed that if you multiply these three, right hand side becomes 1, and all these values which we asked to prove, on the left hand side were numerator, and on the right hand side were denominator. So we multiplied all these three equations and we got the answer. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.